Please, Dad. You may be seated. And who is giving this woman to be married to this man?
The mother.
God's giving her. Dearly beloved, we're assembled in the presence of God to unite this man and this woman in holy matrimony. Instituted by God, regulated by his commandments, and blessed by our Lord Jesus Christ, and to be held in high honor among all men. This sacred relationship is to be entered into soberly, advisory, discreetly, and reverently, and in the fear of God. Into this beautiful and wonderful and holy relationship these two people desire now to enter into. They desire to take each other as husband and wife for prosperity or adversity, sickness or health, property or riches, and to perform all the responsibilities belonging to such a relationship all the way till the end of their lives. To some of these responsibilities as laid down in the Holy Scriptures, I now would like to call to your attentions. God said, "It is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helpmate." The Lord declared, "For this cause shall a man leave his father and his mother, shall cleave to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh." And the Apostle Paul, speaking by the Holy Spirit, said, "Husbands, love your wife, even as Christ loved the church and gave himself for it." And also may the spirit of Ruth, the ancestress of our Lord, accompany this couple as they journey through life together. Entreat me not to leave thee, or to return or follow after thee. For where you go, I will go, and where you lodge, I will lodge. Your people will be my people, and your God, my God. The Word of God shares in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4 through 8, is God's description of love. It says, "Charity suffereth long, and it's kind. Charity envieth not. Charity doesn't want what it says to have, and it's not puffed up. It doesn't behave itself unseemly. It doesn't seek for its own, and it's not easily provoked. It thinketh no evil. It rejoices not in iniquity, but it rejoices in truth. It beareth all things, believeth all things, hopeth all things, and endureth all things. Charity never fails. For where there be prophecies, they will fail. Where there be tongues, they shall cease, and where there will be knowledge, it shall vanish away." Now, you've probably heard that verse many times at weddings and other events, but have you really thought, what does it mean? It means that love is not just a feeling. It's not something you can fall into and fall out of in a whim. Love is a commitment. It's a deliberate decision to do loving things. It's a deliberate decision to be patient and kind. It's a deliberate decision not to be envious, boastful, proud, or rude, or self-seeking. It's a deliberate decision not to be easily angered. and to persevere for each other and not remember past wrongs, but to always protect and trust and hope. Love doesn't just happen, and I assure you, sometimes it can be hard work. It's that commitment and that deliberate decision that you're making here today. Alena and Scott, as you start this journey together, I want you to just remember the very simple words of advice. Let your love be stronger than your anger. Learn the wisdom of compromise. It's far better to bend than to break. Confide in each other and ask for help if and when you may need it. Always, always be best friends. Never take each other for granted. And most importantly, remember to be in love each and every single day. Thank you. I charge you both, as you stand in the presence of God, to remember that love and loyalty alone will avail as a foundation of a happy home. If the solemn vows you are about to make be kept faithfully, and if you steadfastly endeavor to do the will of your Heavenly Father, your life will be full of joy, and the home that you're establishing will abide in peace. I entreat you both to seek God's help in this sacred moment, to look to Him steadfastly for His love and grace, which will make your marriage rich in comfort and faithful in service. Scott, you take Alena as your wife, to cherish her, to love her according to God's holy ordinance. We pledge your loyalty to her and promise to love, honor, comfort, and keep her in health and in sickness, in prosperity and adversity, and to keep yourself under her alone so long as you both shall live. If so, answer, I do. Alena, do you take Scott as your wedded husband, to cherish him, to love him according to God's holy ordinance? We pledge your loyalty to him and promise to love, honor, comfort, and keep him in health and in sickness, in prosperity and adversity, and keep yourself only unto him as long as you both shall live. If so, answer, I do. Let's pray. Gracious God, Spirit of life and love, we ask all your blessings upon Alena and Scott and their life together. May they be blessed with patience to see them through times of tension and conflict. May they be blessed with kindness to enable them to nurture and care for one another in times of pain and sorrow. May they be blessed with the spirit of play and joyfulness, that they may fully participate in the beauties and pleasure of creation. And may they be blessed finally with the knowledge of the ever-flowing presence of love in the world, that they may be channels of this love to one another and all that they meet in their life's journey. Amen. Well, may I have the rings, please? Thank you. In the token of your readiness to assume these obligations, will you please hold hands as you share your marriage covenant vows? Scott, place a ring on Alena's finger. Repeat after me. I, Scott Gregory Christian, take the Alena Jean Parent to be my wedded wife, to have and hold from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part, according to God's holy ordinances, and as a token thereof I give you this ring. To thee I pledge thee my faith. Take me, Scott Gregory Christian, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part, according to God's holy ordinances, and a token of I give you this ring. I do pledge thee my faith. Thank you. Let's pray. Father, we come here today asking your blessing upon these two lives in this home that's being established. You've made it so that we're incomplete without the other, so that we yearn for someone whom we love, whose love we can receive. We're so thankful for the love we see here, and even more for the love we feel from you. May we never take your love for granted. We pray that your love will protect God and Alena. When joy comes, may they share it together. When sorrow threatens, may they bear it together. In gladness or in tears, may they ever draw closer and nearer to you. We ask for health, long life, and the fulfillment of every good dream, and may their love continue throughout this life and finally blend into the eternal. Through Christ's name we pray. Amen. Well, Scott, Alena, you now have openly declared your wishes to unite in holy matrimony. In the presence of these witnesses, you have promised faith and devotion to each other, and you seal these promises by the giving and receiving of rings. By the authority committed to me as a minister of the gospel, it's my greatest joy, honor, and privilege to declare at this moment, Scott and Alena, you're now officially husband and wife. Now, according to the ordinances of God and the law of the state, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen, whom therefore God hath joined together, let not man put asunder. I'd like to share a blessing at this time. Alena, Scott, you now have the opportunity for expressing through this union and partnership God's glory, his love, and his healing. But how could that be? It's going to be through devotion and service to each other, through patience, kindness, total acceptance of one another, tempered by the willingness to change. You'll be tempted, as time goes by, to take for granted the love which seems so precious and dear, to speak and treat each other in ways that do not reflect the highest good in both of you. If and when those times may come, I ask that you strongly resist it. Promise always to see the goodness in your partner, even when it may be difficult. God will provide a way for you if you're willing. He is going to be the key to success as a married couple. I ask that you call on him devotedly and constantly to guide your thinking and to bless your home. And may this marriage be a heavenly sanctuary to both of you. God richly bless you. At this time, before we do the formal pronouncement, I have a short announcement I'd like to make. I would like to request everyone to please remain seated and wait to be ushered out. Alena and Scott would love the opportunity to thank you all for sharing this special day with them. Immediately following, there will be a receiving near the exit of the atrium. Afterwards, you're all invited to the reception area, which will start around 7:15, and there will be hors d'oeuvres served to all outside the ballroom prior to the reception. Now, family and friends, we've come to celebrate for the first time. I would love to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Scott and Alena Christian. Scott, you've been waiting for this moment. You know what's next? Kiss your bride.
Thank you. Joshua Karan, brother of the bride, friend of the groom. Catherine Wainio, cousin of the bride, and groomsman Aaron Caron, brother of the bride, friend of the groom. We now have Linnea Caron, sister of the bride, and groomsman Jacob Torbinen, friend of the groom. Alena Christian.
just can't wait to get pizza.
Thank you.
So, hello, I'm Ross Christian. I'm Scott's younger brother, as all of you may know. I just want to say I'm honored to be here, stand up in Scott's wedding, and I'm just honored to be his best man. So, growing up, me and Scott were just automatically best friends. We had a ton of fun growing up and just shared a ton of awesome memories. However, I always knew the day would come, Scott, that you'd find the love of your life, and it's Alena. So, I'm just proud to say, or proud to have Alena in the family. I can see that Scott and Alena are meant for each other and how God's hand was in their coming together. So I'm definitely gonna miss my brother, but him and Scott and Alena just bought a house actually in our neighborhood. So if I ever miss him too much, I can literally just walk right down the street and visit. So Scott, I'm extremely proud of you, man. You're a good and godly man, and I'm honored to call you my brother. So if we all could just raise our glasses to Scott and Alena and make a toast. May God bless your marriage. Have a great time, Maui, and Alena, welcome to the family.
Hello everybody. For those of you that do not know me, I'm Johanna Caron, Alena's younger sister. First of all, Alena, I'd like to thank you for choosing me as your maid of honor on your special day. I'm very honored. You found the man of your dreams, and I couldn't be happier for you. I know we are 6 years apart in age, but we have both gotten closer, we've gotten older, and I'm thankful for that. We've gotten closer. I remember when I started working with you at Pet Supplies Plus, it was my first real job, and you were my manager. For some reason, you were always harder on me than the other employees. Probably because I was your little sister. It's all right though, I learned a lot from that job and it really helped me a lot of ways. Scott, you've got a good one. For one thing, I know Alena knows how to cook and bake. When we were growing up, I remember her baking all sorts of specialty foods for us, like homemade caramels, fried Oreos, little cheesecake bites, cinnamon roll pancakes. And I promise she does know how to cook healthy meals and not only sweets. I remember when you and Ross started first coming over and hanging out with Aaron and Josh. You always took the time to hang out with my younger siblings and I, and we were always excited for you to come over because we always had a good time. You definitely got lots of exercise, chasing the younger ones around the yard and giving them piggyback rides. I know you're going to make a great dad someday, and I can't wait to be an aunt. Hint, hint. I just want to say that I honestly never would imagine you guys would get together, but I am so happy for you guys. Scott, welcome to the family. I pray God blesses your life together. I love you both and wish you both the very best. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Jacob Torbin. I'm a friend of the Christian and the Caron family. Just want to start by saying congratulations to the happy couple. Totally awesome. I've known both the Caron and the Christian family my entire life. Grew up with both of them. Grew up with the families all being apart, basically. We moved to Chicago a few years back, and then we came back. We actually had an event that had all the families come together. Really cool to see. That is when the Carons and Christians first met, and it was really cool to see what came of it. Who would have thought? God is really good. This was really cool. Scott and I were talking recently about just how his timing and his hand and everything, just talking about how perfect it is, and it's just really, really awesome. Really, really big blessing. My best advice for you guys is make sure you keep God first. Remember, keep him first and foremost. So it's God, your spouse, and then your family right after. So just good luck to you guys and enjoy your honeymoon.
Caron, Alena's sister-in-law. I'm married to her amazing younger brother, Josh. I'm going to start by telling you a little about their love story. So my husband, Josh, and his brother, Aaron, met Scott and Ross about 7 years ago. Alena saw him at her parents, but didn't hang out with them until I moved to Michigan in 2015. It all really started in the beginning of 2018. I remember we were all at the guy's house for New Year's Eve playing card games, and like usual, Alena kept organizing her cards all neatly on the table, and Scott would reach over and mess up her cards, And Alena would say, stop! But laugh and not get mad like she normally would if anyone else did that. I was thinking, what is going on here? Then Scott would always steal her phone from her. She would chase him around the house, and sometimes he would hide it from her, like on top of the fan. And the rest is history. It was definitely weird seeing them together at first. I would have never guessed they would end up together, but now I can't imagine them without each other. Alena, we have so many memories together from youth camp, Silver Lake, Cedar Point, New Hampshire for my wedding, and much more. Then, of course, all the day-to-day things since we lived together from when I moved to Michigan until you just moved out this June. There's nothing like trying to share space and bills with your friend. Of course, we never had any arguments, especially about the dishes in the sink. Let's just say our relationship has improved since you moved out, right, Alena? Oh, and thanks for all the beauty hacks over the years. Scott, I am happy she found someone like you who thinks her quirks, like counting out her carrots and almonds, is cute. I would tell you to take good care of her, but I know you will. Just remember, Scott, Android is better than Apple. I'm so happy for you both. Marriage is such a blessing. My marriage advice would be to remember to say I love you, listen to each other, compromise, be open with each other, and remember your vows. I pray that God will bless your marriage today and always. Enjoy your honeymoon in Hawaii. Congratulations. Thank you.
Well, I'm coming from a different angle because I'm the mom of the groom, so mine's a little sappier. But I just want to say, before I go to my speech, it's been a real pleasure knowing the Karan family. You guys are really great people, and I'm so thankful that we can be a part of the family together with you guys. So Scott and Alena, I can't believe this day has finally arrived. I remember someone saying to me a long time ago, children are a blessing, so enjoy the time you have with your children. They grow up so fast, and before you know it, they're leaving home. And I took that advice, and I enjoyed the time I had with my boys to the fullest. I would pray every morning before the boys got up to have patience, that what I did that day would be sufficient, and enjoy the time I had with my children that day. As I home educated my boys, one of our first lessons of the day was always Bible study, followed by prayer time. This prayer time is something that is closely shared in our family and something special between Scott and I. There have been many prayer sessions for his safety and direction. Throughout the years, we prayed for Scott's future spouse and to prepare him to be a good husband someday. Scott held on to those prayers and they were answered, and here we are. I sometimes miss some of the days that have gone by when the boys were little, but I'm so proud of my sons today, especially as we are honoring this beautiful marriage and the fact that our Heavenly Father answered our prayers with Alena. I'm happy to say that I enjoyed every phase of childhood with Scott, and now I am so blessed by the man he has turned out to be. I know that he will be a wonderful husband, love and honor his wife, take care of her, and be her protector. I also know that Scott will be a wonderful father to his children and be a good family man. Most of all, I know Scott's faith in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, will help him to continue to be the solid man in marriage, in good and in bad times. I love you, son, more than words can say. Alena, you are a blessing to us, and we are so happy that you have become a part of our family. May the both of you know that you have our love, support, and prayers now and always.
All right, now it's time for the shoe game. Can I please get the bride and groom take their seats in front of the bridal table?
Otherwise, yeah. Who is better at remembering important dates?
What?
Important dates.
Two for two.
Who gives better advice? Who is more stubborn? Who's made the first move? Who is more romantic? Who takes longest to get ready? Who is the healthier eater? Who is the bigger spender? Who is the better gift giver?
What is it?
Gift giver.
Better gift giver.
Who has more shoes?
Are you sure? Are you sure?
Yes.
Oh, yeah,
welcome.
Who's neater?
Come on.
Which spouse is older? Which spouse is older? Who is the better driver? Who do you love most in the world?
Stop it! Somebody told me to throw these at him. That's
Stephanie told me to throw these.
Hey, look here.
So I'm following order.
Jerry, come back a little bit. Come on. Jerry, come back a little bit. Alena.
Jerry, get off the floor.
Hey, Jerry, get out of the way.
You caught it in the
face. Hey, I'll take one more.
He has the rest of the game. He did the whole
attacks. No shark attacks. Oh, I'm sorry. Not giving you bad dreams.
It's terrible.
Bye,
love you!
Enjoy Taco Bell.
Enjoy Taco Bell.